That's a great reminder you are able to use the project browser in order to look for all the families that are associated to the project, meaning that in here we are going to be able to find the families that are loaded by default with the template, but also the families that we loaded to the project. So in here you're going to find the families, but also by using the right click, you're able to change the properties by using the Type Properties window, as you normally would do by selecting the family. So I'm going to continue by playing with the remaining properties that I'm going to be using for this stair, so you can get an idea of how this railing is going to be. However, as I mentioned, if you use this railing on a straight segment, you are going to be able to see that it works just fine. So instead of creating different families or re-editing the baluster, I'm just going to be using this family for the exteriors so I can later use another one for the stair that I just created. Now, this doesn't mean there are no properties that you can use in order to improve the appearance of the railing, such as the one that is called Use Length and Height Adjustment, which allows you to improve the connection between the railing that you have on the landing with the railing that you have on the slope. Now this doesn't actually change the slope for the railing, however it will change the point when the railings connect. So this part is a little bit tricky, however in this case I will just use a different railing for this stair that is actually more suited for this particular purpose. but also you're able to edit families that you already created within the project or that you already placed within the project, such as for example the elevator. So if I open another view or create another view in which I'm able to see the elevator, I'm going to be able to edit the family for the elevator in order to make sure that we're able to control the elements that we want to see on the project. So with this, I'm going to modify the family element visibility settings in order to hide and unhide a few elements depending on the view, but also depending on the detail levels. And once that you have done this, you are going to see how this actually looks once you load it to the project. Now, since I already created a baluster, I can create another baluster using as a reference the baluster that I already created. So this will mean that I will be able to edit not only the elevator, but also the baluster family that I created before. And with this in mind, I'm going to save this baluster under a different name. And once I load this baluster to the project, I'm going to be able to use this baluster with the railing for the stair. So I'm going to change the properties of the railing for the stair, but also the remaining railings in which I'm using these families.